So let's start with the oldest one, and it's from 1910, so more than 100 years ago, an Audi Type A Phaeton. Great details, it must be a Spark model. It has absolutely fantastic details. It has some leather couches, wooden steering wheel. The dashboard is very detailed, quite hard to see on the camera, but you'll need to believe me, it's very detailed. You'll have those very cool wooden rims. Awesome, awesome car. I absolutely love the design of this car, and I'm quite a big fan of those cars from the beginning of the 19th century. So nice model. A car that I like even more, from 1945, also from Spark, an Audi Front 225 Roadster, and it was the first time when I saw that car. These two cars are bought from that Facebook page, Lumea Machetelor, or World of Cars. I spoke about that page before, and I quite recommend to check it out. I actually will let a link in the description of this clip, so if you want to see it, check it out, you might enjoy it. So from that Facebook page, I also got this gorgeous looking Audi with fantastic looking details, and it was a real surprise for me because I didn't expect to see this type of model of an Audi. I had no idea this one exists. Now, if you know more about it, please let me know. I would be very happy to find out more. But the details on this model, awesome, awesome, awesome details. Love the rims, love the handles of the engine cover that you, in theory, should be able to remove it. Love the dashboard. The seats are from burgundy leather. So, absolutely fantastic details. I'm more than amazed about the details of these model cars. So, XO, as you saw with the Aston Martin, made a series with all the Le Mans winners. So, the number one at Le Mans in each year. And you will have, because this is the Aston Martin right here, you'll have the year of the competition, the car, and the name of the drivers, of course, on the side, in white. They also did a similar thing for the cars that took the second place at Le Mans, which is also very cool. That's also the case for this very nice looking Audi R8. That has nothing to do with the normal, the road version Audi R8. And also, it doesn't have the year right here. It has a code, a product code. But on the side, in yellow, you'll have the Audi R8, the team, the second place at Le Mans in 2002, and the name of the drivers, of course. You'll see that the details are identical with the previous model from XO, and they are quite good, more than decent. So again, a product where the price quality ratio is very good. The only problem with this model is that it doesn't want to go out. Okay, so it's out. Typical racing car for that period of time. Great looking one. It took the second place at Le Mans in 2002. It was driven by Pescaroli, one of the greatest drivers at Le Mans. So very, very nice looking car with great details provided by XO. I really like it. This car is the first model car that I receive as a gift from somebody without any particular reason. I received gifts before from persons that I used to buy medium amount of cars, but hey, more than 1, 2, 3 cars. And from time to time, I used to receive one model car as a bonus. But this time, MC Lab, great guy, great channel, check it out. I will also leave a link in the description. Presented this car on his channel. I left him a comment stating that this is a great model car and that I don't have it and that I need to search for one in the near future because I only have the newer version of the Q7. And he decided, with no reason, to send it to me. So, great car, great gesture, really appreciate it. And as I presented, I think that last week, this is a very cool looking Q7. So, I will add it here, and very nice addition. Good. Now, and again, MC Lab, thanks a lot. Audi R8 LMS from the 24 Hours of Nürburgring from 2009. As you can see, the box is a Schuco one. Check out the next week video because I will start unboxing a box full of Schuco models. You'll like that. That being said, this is the type of R8 that we are used to. So, not this one because this is also an R8, but we are more used with this one. And this is an absolute beauty. It has an Audi specific livery, awesome details. It is the first generation of Audi R8 with great details. Schuco did an absolutely fantastic job. This is the first moment when I'm seeing that it has the front left headlights missing. I don't mind. It will also have a great place in my collection and I really, really like it. But see, sometimes it's good to make videos like this in order to see if the model cars you bought have some damages or not. Cool. Two more Audis to go and we will have a DTM vehicle. This time from 2012 from Spark, a very cool looking Audi A5. Also specific Audi Ultra livery. Great details, great rims. You cannot see an interior, something that is quite strange. Usually with all my DTM cars, you'll have a very detailed interior. Now, if you are paying close attention, you'll see that the interior has a roll box. So I don't expect to be blank like in case of concept cars. But all the windows are dark, so it's almost impossible to see inside. I don't know why, but the model car looks very, very, very cool. Good. And the last model car from Audi, it will be of course a more modern one, and if we started with something from 1910, now we will have an electric car, an Audi e-tron Sportsback. I'm also searching for the Audi e-tron GT, the sportier version, but until then, this electric SUV is a very, very nice looking model. From I-Scale, with more than decent details to be honest, I really like this blue. And the details on this electric car. I'm not the biggest fan of the electric cars. I don't have something against them, to be honest. But I'm not the biggest fan of all design of electric cars. Not the case for this Audi, as I really like how it looks. And from my perspective, it is also a nice model for the collection. And with that, we ended the letter A. But as you can see, we still have more than a bunch of model cars to present. So let's move to letter B.